the Lord your God.
It was fitting that we should have such a high priest.
It is possible to love everyone, even those that we find difficult to love, who might turn us off or not, maybe not be very attractive. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace, mercy, peace from God our Father through the risen Savior be with you always.
And with your spirit.
In order to prepare our hearts to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we take a moment to acknowledge our need for the Lord's healing, mercy, and forgiveness. Lord, you came to draw all people into the peace of God's reign. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, you anoint us as ambassadors of the gospel. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, you pour out your life for us all. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to life everlasting.
Amen.
We pray for a moment in the quiet of our hearts. Lord our God, you are the one God and there is no other. Give us grace to hear and heed the great commandment of your kingdom, that we may love you with all our heart and love our neighbor as ourselves. We ask this through Jesus, our Lord and brother, who lives with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
proclamation from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to the people, saying, "Fear the Lord your God, and keep throughout the days of your lives all his statutes and commandments, which I enjoin on you, and thus have a long life. Hear then, Israel, and be careful to observe them, that you may grow and prosper the more, in keeping with the promise of the Lord, the God of your fathers, to give you a land flowing with milk and honey. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. Therefore, you shall love the Lord, your God, with all your heart and all your soul and all your strength. Take to heart these words, which I enjoin on you today. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A proclamation from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, the Levitical priests were many because they were prevented by death from remaining in office. But Jesus, because he remains forever, has a priesthood that does not pass away. Therefore, he is always able to save those who approach God through him, since he lives forever to make intercession for them. It was fitting that we should have such a high priest, holy, innocent, undefiled, separated from sinners, higher than the heavens. He has no need, as did the high priest, to offer sacrifice day after day. For first his own sins he took from them, and it's from them and for these on these days he did this once for all when he offered himself. For the law appoints men subject to weakness to be high priest, but the word of the oath which was taken after the law appoints a son who has been made perfect forever. The word of the Lord.
With you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of good news according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
May the Lord be in our minds, on our lips, and in our hearts. One of the scribes came to Jesus and asked him, "Which is the first of all the commandments?" Jesus replied, "This is the first. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these." The scribe said to him, "Well said, teacher. You are right in saying, 'He is one, and there is no other than He.' And to love Him with all your heart, with all your understanding, with all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself is worth more than all burnt offerings and sacrifices." And when Jesus saw that he answered with understanding, he said to him, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." And no one dared to ask him any more questions. The Gospel of the Lord. During my first year as a Capuchin Franciscan, we didn't get out of the monastery very much. It was kind of like a year-long retreat. So we looked for different ways to entertain ourselves within the confines of the monastery. And some of us who were a little more musically inclined, we decided we would put on a musical play. And this was 1970, so what was kind of popular at the time was, "You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown." So we got the script, we worked at that, and of course we were a community of all men, and there are two girls in the play, Lucy, of course, and Peppermint Patty. And how ironic it was that the two that played the two girls in the play both had beards. The one who played Lucy and I was Peppermint Patty. But I've come to appreciate sort of the homespun wisdom that comes from the Peanuts cartoons, the Peanuts comics, the Peanuts characters. They really put things very starkly, very simply, and they cause you to think. And so there is one comic strip in which I believe it was Linus who's philosophizing for Charlie Brown, and he says, "You know, Charlie Brown, I love humanity. It's people I can't stand." Wow, doesn't that point out the struggle we have? Of course we all love humanity, but when it comes down to individuals, sometimes it's pretty difficult to love. And so I think Jesus is calling us to embrace that universal call to love. And what wisdom he has when he says to love your neighbor as yourself, he doesn't use the word like. Of course, we're all limited. We have different personalities. We're not able to like everyone. That's just the way we're all wired. But it is possible to love everyone, even those that we find difficult to love, who might turn us off, or not, maybe not be very attractive, or maybe would be scoundrels. Love is beyond feeling. Love is a decision to wish what's best for the next person. A decision to conduct myself with that individual that I might find difficult to like, to conduct them the way I would want them to treat me. What a powerful message Jesus has. And he puts it on the same level with the first commandment. When Jesus quotes that great Pledge of Allegiance that pious Jews say to this day, 2 to 3 times a day, "The Lord our God is Lord alone." You know, the Jewish people put a little thing on their door called a mezuzah, and within that little scroll is that scripture we heard from the first reading, reminding the people of their wholehearted, total allegiance to God. And when they come and they go, they touch that mezuzah as a reminder that their days are to be wholeheartedly directed to God. And the pious Jews often wear what's called phylacteries, where they would put that same scripture in a little box and tie it around their head and tie it on their wrists. All concrete ways to remind themselves that they're called to be totally, wholeheartedly devoted to God. God is first. God is the priority. And how radical for Jesus then to put the love of neighbor on that same level. Love your neighbor as yourself. You know, it was common at the time of Jesus that people would ask their rabbi which of the commandments were more important, because they had hundreds of rules and laws and regulations. And so Jesus answers perfectly, of course, that wholehearted commitment to God, but then saying, love your neighbor as yourself. What a challenge, what an inspiration. And if we can grow in absorbing those two basic perspectives, there's less need to worry about all hundreds of others of rules and regulations. You can see why Jesus often got into hot water with the religious leaders of his day. He himself was living that, putting his heavenly Father first and putting the needs of people with that. And so sometimes the needs of people contradicted particular rules, laws, and regulations. That's the great commandment Jesus passes on to us. And so I don't think we have the custom in our homes of having a mezuzah on the door, but hopefully we have a crucifix somewhere in our homes, a crucifix to remind us of God's love for us and to kind of remind us of our love for God, returning that same love by the ways in which we love our neighbor. St. John writes that, how can you say you love God whom you do not see if you do not love your neighbor whom you do see? Another way of saying, how can you say, I love humanity, it's people I can't stand? And so hopefully we find ways to remind ourselves of that daily in our homes. Hopefully at least there's a crucifix or a cross. I know years ago people used to also have little holy water font. I don't know if people still do that, but it's another reminder of our baptism, that we're called day in and day out to live life in Christ. And so the two great commandments today are given to us as our daily bread to help further us along in responding to our God. None of us could love God or our neighbor if God did not first love us, even when we are unlovable. Maybe you recall that very simple children's Bible song from Sunday school. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. Can you all sing that? Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. Linus and Peppermint Patty would approve of that. Please turn to page 10. Some have questioned, why did we go back to the old creed? Well, this is not the old creed. This is the new translation of the Apostles' Creed. And the Apostles' Creed is even more ancient than the Nicene Creed, and it's one of the legitimate approved options for renewing our faith. So we haven't gone back to the old creed. We're praying the new translation of the more simplified ancient creed, the Apostles' Creed. Together.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord,
We now call upon God to hear and answer the prayers we voice in the name of Jesus.
Our prayer this morning is, "Hear us, O Lord." For the church, for the grace to grow in holiness and to witness God's love for all people. O God, we pray,
hear us, O Lord.
For non-violent solutions to all conflict, for understanding, cooperation, and compassion among the citizens of nations who are at war. O God, we pray,
hear us, Lord.
For an increase of patience, gentleness, tolerance, care, attention, appreciation, and gratitude among us. O God, we pray,
hear us.
For all of us gathered here today, that as citizens of this country, we may recognize our baptismal commitment to vote as informed people, faithful to the moral, social, and common good of us all. O God, we pray,
hear us.
For families suffering loss and damage due to the hurricane on the East Coast, may they experience Jesus in the helping hands of others. O God, we pray,
hear us.
For those who accepted our invitation to return home to the church, that they may be blessed with a renewal of faith and a closer relationship with the Lord. O God, we pray,
hear us.
Let us remember the sick who have asked for our prayers, the homebound and hospitalized, the chronically ill, and for their caregivers and loved ones who witness their suffering. O God, we pray,
hear us.
We remember those who are signed in our Book of Life. For John Bodelik, who recently died. For all those we love and miss, and especially for Ralph Eberly, Eva Marshall, and Terry Boho, for whom this Eucharist is offered. O God, we pray.
Hear us. God of love, you are the source of all power. Hear the prayer of your people gathered to love and serve you. Help us to serve each other so that we may come closer to your kingdom, where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Our presentation song can be found on page 23. We give you thanks on page 23.
Thank you.
Pray, friends, that these our gifts may be acceptable to God, our loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and for all of God's holy church.
Amen. Lord God, let this sacrifice be a pure and spotless offering to you, and let it bring to us the rich outpouring of your mercy. For we pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Creator of the world and fount of all life. You never abandon the creatures formed by your wisdom, but remain with us always, working for our good. With mighty hand and outstretched arm, you led your people Israel through the desert. Today, by the power of the Holy Spirit, you guide your pilgrim church as we journey along the path of time to the eternal joy of your kingdom through Jesus Christ. Now with all the angels and all the saints, we sing a hymn to your glory. Indeed are you, Lord God, greatly to be praised. Your faithful love attends us as we journey through life. Blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ, who is present among us when his love gathers us together. As once he did for his disciples, Christ now opens the scriptures for us and breaks the bread. Therefore we ask you, merciful Father, send down your Holy Spirit to hallow these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the eve of his passion and death, while at table with those he loved, he took bread and gave you thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks. And giving the cup to his disciples, he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me."
Thank you.
And so, Father most holy, we celebrate the memory of Christ your Son, whom you led through suffering and death on the cross, to the glory of the resurrection and a place at your right hand. Until Jesus, our Savior, comes again, we proclaim the work of your love, offering you the bread of life and the cup of blessing. Look with favor on the offering of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that was handed on to us. Through the power of your Spirit of love, count us both now and forever among the members of your Son, whose body and blood we share. Strengthen in unity those you have called to this table, together with Benedict our Pope, Jerome and Donald our bishops, with all bishops, priests, deacons, religious, all your holy people, may we follow your paths in faith and hope, spreading joy and trust in the world. Be mindful of our loved ones who have died in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith is known only to you. Lead them to the fullness of the resurrection. Gladden them with the light of your face. When our pilgrimage on earth is complete, welcome us into your heavenly home to dwell with you forever. There with Mary and Joseph, the apostles, the martyrs, Saint James, and all the saints, we shall glorify your name and give you praise through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Together we pray in confidence with the words Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
And may the peace of the Lord Jesus be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We share a sign of the Lord's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, our way, our truth, and our life. How blessed are we called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be
healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus bring us to life everlasting. Invite forward the ministers of communion for the homebound. We're very grateful for your willingness to bring the Eucharist to those who can't be here, that they too can deepen in their relationship with the Lord and know our prayers for them. And we send you then with the sign of the cross in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, increase within us the work of your saving power, that our lives may be renewed by these holy mysteries, and your grace may prepare us for the blessings they promise. We make our prayer through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Our announcements for this weekend. Anointing of the sick will take place on the 10th and 11th of November, that's next weekend, after all masses. If you would like to be anointed, please stop in the gathering space for a name tag as you arrive. Our November Jacob's Ladder is ready. Please bring pictures of your deceased loved ones to remember throughout the month of November. There will be an important art and environment planning meeting for our Christmas season on Monday, November 5th at 6:30 in the Great Room. Anyone interested in helping with decorating for Christmas is encouraged to attend. We need your help, so please consider joining us. On November 18th, the Cooperating Churches of Sussex is holding a mini work camp reunion dinner for the seniors who have participated in mini work camp in the past. We are looking for food donations for the dinner. Please check the bulletin to see what's needed and give us a call if you can help. Attention ushers. Please note there will be an important meeting of all ushers on Monday night, November 5th at 6:30 in the gathering space. Please see the bulletin and website for more information and activities on our parish.
Just a slight correction about the anointing. next week. It will be right within the Mass. It will be a part of the Mass following the homily. Father Jerry will be here to also assist with the anointing of the sick. And we continue to keep John Bodelick in our prayers, as well as his family, for their healing and consolation. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
This is our hospitality weekend, so please spend some time visiting in the gathering space after Mass. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
And as we are sent forth this morning, please turn to page 16 and let's sing together Canticle of the Sun.